Good morning, everyone. Today we're here on Mount Hagadol, and today we're joined by a very special guest, Chef Ito. He's the head chef of Saikon, the temple lodging and restaurant right next to the Dewa San San Shrine at the top of Mount Hagadol. And today we have a very special experience planned. Together with Chef Ito, we're going to go into the forest, harvest various types of sansai, and then together back at Saikon, we're going to make shojin yori, which is the traditional mountain monk food of the Dewa San San Mountains. So first of all, we're going to go into the bamboo forest here, and we're going to harvest moso, which is bamboo shoots.
Okay, so unfortunately we had some audio trouble. Chef Ito's mic was on, mine was off. Anyways, we're using a hoe just like that, and we're going into the forest. And as we went into the forest, what was interesting is that Chef Ito told me that, you know, normally this would be a two-person job, because when we found the bamboo shoots, it'd usually be covered in small trees, branches, so one person would have to hold it back while the other person harvests the bamboo shoots. Right here, Chef Ito, he's explaining to me how to get the bamboo shoots out of the ground. So right now he's saying that, you know, when we harvest the bamboo shoots, we actually have to harvest them beneath the soil, just beneath the soil. And he's saying that we have to hit the bamboo shoots at about a 30 or 45 degree angle. And once we wedge in the hoe into the bamboo shoot, we can kind of leverage, you know, kind of just like pull out the bamboo shoot just like that.
場所によってですね、こう土が硬かったり、ほらこのように石があったりしますんで、こういうものを避けて掘らないとですね、手も痛くなりますので。よいしょ。はい、取れました。
All right, so we got our takenoko here from the forest, and now we're going to go into the mountain to harvest other types of sansai. Ito-san, 毎日どのくらい妄想取れますか？
お客さんに合わせてですので、毎日取るわけではないんですよ。
忙しい日だけにどのくらい取れますか？
もう、例えばこのコンテナで3つも4つも取ります。
So he says maybe that's probably about 20 or 30 of these. Hard work! では山に行きましょう。
はい。
Okay, so now we're following Chef Ito up to Saikon. And normally you can hike up Mount Hagadol, but you can also take this road to drive directly to the Dewa San San Shrine. Okay, so now we're at Saikon with Chef Ito. And actually, Saikon's built around, it's built in the middle of the forest. So we can actually harvest the vegetables we need just outside of his lodge. Okay, so the first type of sansai that we're taking here today is this. It's called Aomizu.And it's a little bit short for this time of year, but he says, Chef Ito said earlier that it's perfect for salad size. So today we're only going to take what we need, so we're not going to take that much.
Niteiru sansai kekko arimasu node, betsu no mono o totte desu ne, tabenai you ni. Nani taberareru ka?
So he's asking me if I know among the vegetation here what can we eat?
セリっていう野菜わかる？
あ、わかります。
うん、スーパーでも売ってるんだけども、こうこの辺に自生してるのは本ゼリ。
本ゼリ。
本当の自然のセリ。
お
お。うん、だから味も濃くて、そのセリ。この辺の全部。
あ、これですか？
それの葉っぱ。
あ、葉っぱ。そう、
ほら、この辺にもあるでしょ？ちょっとだけ茎を入れて。
本セリ
ちょっと食べられる。だから厨房で料理をしててちょっと緑が足りないっていう時には誰がトトトンって走ってきてこういうものを取ってすぐ添えるってこと、料理に添えるってことができるわけです。
Okay, so now we're a bit deeper in the forest now, and we're here for our next type of sansai right here. This is called Akamizu, and it's a bit different from the earlier one that we were harvesting.If you look here, the stems right here, they're actually red, and they're a bit harder, they're a bit more firm than the Aomizu that we were harvesting earlier. And Ito-san, he explained that we can actually eat this entire plant. Like the leaves we can make into tempura, and then the stems here we could use for various other types of cooking.
ちょっと茹でるとき見せられると思うけど。
はい。So Chef Ito said that the red parts, that once we put them in hot water, that the red will turn to green. So he says it's an interesting change that we'll see inside his kitchen.
こんな形で。
Okay, so this is our last type of sansai that we're gathering. It's called aiko. And if you look here, it has tiny spines all over its stems. So that's why we had gloves and scissors for this. So now we're going to take our sansai, we're going to go into Saikon, and we're going to cook it. Alright, so now we're in Saikon. We have a very special chance to go inside the kitchen of Chef Ito. And from now, he's going to be preparing mosso and all the other types of sansai that we harvested. Today, I'm mostly going to leave it to Chef Ito to cook it, and we'll just film and just watch how he does it.
今あの下の方で取ってきた妄想なんですけれども、これを、まあ、下処理するわけなんですけれども、これをですね、この上の部分、身が入ってない部分をですね落とします。そしてこの下の部分ですね、この硬い部分も落とします。こんな形にしますね。でちょっとだけ皮を落としてですね、この状態で、下茹でします。大体そうですね、1時間半から2時間ぐらい下茹でしてですね、ちなみにさっきのこの妄想なんですけれども、これを約2時間ぐらい茹でてアク抜きするとこんな形になります、ね、でこんな形になってからこう初めてこう皮を剥く、食べられるところまでこう剥いていって、もうこれは全部食べられます。こんなに大きかったんですけれども、皮を剥くとこんなになります。でこの妄想だけで、炊き込みご飯を作るとこうなります。それから今取ってきたこの山菜ですけれども、この赤水はですね、まずこのゆめちゃん、葉の部分を落としながらこう皮を剥いていきます、このぐらいの厚さというか細さというか、こんな形にカットしてですね、ご飯と一緒に炊き込みます。落としながらこう皮が、ね、剥けるのが分かりますか。皮ね、これ皮ね。でこの葉っぱは葉っぱで後で天ぷらにして食べられるんですけれども、今食べるのはこの茎の部分ですのでね、このぐらい今剥いたんですけれども、こちらをですね、この茹でていきます。これ茹でるとですね、さっき言った通りこの赤い部分がですね全部緑色に変わります。赤水ですね、これを今から茹でます。今皮を剥いただけの状態の赤水です。今取ってきたばっかりの赤水入れますよ。はい、入れます、ね、緑に変わったの分かりますか。こんな形で全部ね、茹でれば綺麗な緑色に変わります。まあ、いろんな食べ方もあるんですけれども、このままそのままお醤油かけて食べるという食べ方もありますけれどもですね、今せっかく取れたてですので、一番簡単な食べ方ということでですね、そしてですね、こういったきゅうりをちょっと入れて、で人参もちょっと足します。これにですね塩を振ります、はい、この状態でですね、だいたい30分ぐらい置きますと少し水がこう出てくるぐらいが食べ頃かと思うんですけれども、今この状態でも十分食べられます。はい、今取ってきたばっかりのこの青水ですね、はい、この程度で大丈夫です。これはですね、このままでは少し食べにくいですので、少しこう食べやすいようにこうカットをして、このままお醤油をかけても食べられますけれども、例えばこの菜館ではですね、ごまだれとかさっとこう黒ごまとですね、お醤油、それからお砂糖で作ったソースです。こういった形ですぐ食べられます。はい、次はこのセリです。茹でるというよりも本当にお湯にちょっとくぐす程度で大丈夫です。これを入れます。 ちょっとお湯の中でこう泳がす程度で大丈夫です。ザルに取ります。はい、こんな形になりますね。これも食べやすいように、例えば細かくカットしたりですね、そして味噌汁とか吸い物にこう放すとかですね、このままでも十分食べられます。やっぱり、山のものですので香りがですね、すごく、このぐらい離れてても香りがするぐらい、基本的に今のこの季節のものはですね、全てのものそうなんですけれども、茹でてちょっとお醤油を垂らすとか、そのぐらいお浸しという食べ方が一番全部味も分かりやすくてですね、美味しいかもしれません。次はアイコを茹でます。これがアイコです、ね、さっき言った通りアイコにはこうトゲがいっぱいありますけれど、私はちょっとトゲが痛いですのでこれでつまみます、ね、こう慣れてる人はトゲは全然痛くないんです。痛い？はい、入れます。お湯すぐなかったかな、今アイコ茹でてますけれども、さっきまでの青水とか赤水、それからセリと違いましてですね、このアイコの場合は本当に茹でるという表現が合ってると思います。3分ぐらいは茹でた方がいいと思います。さっきまであったこの白いこう産毛トゲがですね、なくなってきて、なくなってきてるっていうか、このトゲ自体がこの柔らかくなりますので、これが全然痛いっていうこともありません。今度はこれもまた水にとってですね、色が変わらないように、包丁に合わせてこう、ね、等間隔でこう、こうやって盛り付けてですね、
Alright, so now it's time for the best part. We're going to try some of the shojin yori that Chef Ito prepared. The flavors of the shojin yori, I've had it many times when I've led tours here, but I will explain that the flavors are very, very pure. It's a very, very light type of cuisine. And even though it's a vegetarian type of cooking, it doesn't use garlic or onions, no pungent flavors. I find that the flavors of shojin yori, the flavors that Chef Ito is able to take out of these ingredients is so incredible. It's very light, very strong flavors. And just the texture of these fresh vegetables, because we just harvested them in the forest, they're incredibly fresh, incredibly light. I've been eating the Sansai dishes today. I really have to add that it's so, so good. My favorite dish, actually, is just it's what's called takikomi gohan. I don't know how he makes this. It might look very simple, but just the complexity of the flavor. It has such strong flavor, and the textures from the bamboo, and say he put some miso skin in it as well. It has such great flavor, such great texture. Imagine like the best fried rice you've ever had. And then imagine it being extremely, extremely healthy for you. That's what this is. It's not fried rice, but it's better than any fried rice I've ever had, if that makes sense. But I'm going to have to ask him exactly how he made this. But every single dish is so good. If you like, if this experience today looked good to you, harvesting vegetables in the forest, cooking together, and eating in Saikon, take a look at our link below, because you could sign up and do exactly this. Also, if you're just going to visit Mount Hogoro, by all means, make a reservation here at Saikon. We'll leave information about that below as well. Because you have to try Chef Ito's cooking. It is so good. His cooking alone, I'll say it, it's worth coming to Yamagata just to come to Saikon and try his cooking. So if you like this video, also please like and subscribe, and please look forward to more videos like this. Thank you.